Here we go. It is UFC. It is fight night. It's time to get going. We got five. I know what I did. It's going to go to the first match. We got some good matches. A couple we had to put together. Two matches are from the card that's going to happen next Thursday. And it just one of the fights co-lined with our lightweight champion, Dos Anjos versus Alvarez. All right, here we go. Got to be quick on the trigger. Got to get quick on the trigger. Oh, yeah, I got who I wanted. Nate Diaz. Any man who knocks out Mace McGregor, tap out, excuse me, is a friend of mine. Get this man a round of applause. From Stockton, California.
Our black belts embracing Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Diaz loves to put on a show. He's very active with his striking. And if he gets his opponent to the mat, he has multiple ways to finish the fight.
Nate Diaz, like his brother,
Ultimate Five winner, Jiu-Jitsu.
Utilizes a long reach, outstanding, accurate boxing, and a world-class Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu game to go with it.
Yeah.
Feels like he's never been better prepared for a fight.
That surprised me, that huge trade against PK Sedan. His captain, much rather, just didn't like PK. Former WEC welterweight champion, his 27 fights in his career, has lost 11 fights, excuse me, in his career. But he's a fan favorite, you get these two. And it was one of the fights that we had to put together. Our booking staff had to put this fight together, and it did a phenomenal job putting this together.
Our tail of the tape for this welterweight bat.
Next week, 200, man. Diaz. Nick is older than Nate.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC. Welterweight division.
No, dude, you don't
know. Bruce Buffer. How's he supposed to get ready for later on tonight?
Special record of 20 wins, 10 losses. He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 170 pounds. Fighting out of Stockton, California, he is an Ultimate Fighter season winner.
No, the only ass here is Conor McGregor. That's another story for another time. That fight happened in August. Diaz McGregor 2. This dude's all over the place. Dude, this dude's gonna be out of gas before the fight starts. Like, for real, for real. That ain't one of the best nickname fights. Go to see a little bit later. Big Country versus the Black Beast. We were having fun with making fun of that before the show.
Referee for this welterweight showcase. And here we go. Interesting matchup here, Joe. Will they try to go for the submission, or will they choose to stand and strike? Nate Diaz has outstanding boxing, a black belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, and is one of the most game guys in the division. He quickly gets this fight to the ground. Beautifully executed sweep. Great transition to top position. Back to full guard. Very nice. Pyle goes into side control. Full guard. Back on their feet. Big left by Diaz. Tagged him. Huge kick to the head lands. Oh, that one hurt him. Big punches.
Diaz does not care.
Hard straight punch. There he is. Got the takedown. See if he looks for a knee. Half
guard. Good move back into half guard. Nate with a nice strike from the bottom. And back to full guard. He's got him in his guard. He's back up again.
Full guard, half guard, full guard, half guard, full guard.
Slip and rip. Misses with a spinning back fist. Excellent head movement. Really consistent with these hooks.
That is Diaz for you. He'll swing.
Joey's looking for an opening for that hook. And Joe, there's a
foul with these takedowns.
Outstanding job with the takedowns, too.
Oh, here we go again.
Back to half guard.
Side control.
And the clinch. Good defense for now. He's got some time to work here. 45 seconds. Looking for the single. That's a big takedown late in the round. Got one overhook and one underhook here. He finishes the takedown late in the round. Final seconds of round number one. And into the guard. Excellent work from the bottom by Diaz.
Diaz with shots from the top. I didn't got one that round from the stand-up position. It's very interesting, man. Paul had the takedowns, but Diaz had this one.
Okay, give me that one. That's only one shot.
But when it was standing up, Diaz was just going to town.
Okay, those are clean shots. Well, I got...
And another perfectly placed strike.
All right. I got the point, Charles.
Brittany.
The beautiful Brittany.
The beautiful Brittany. Didn't cover all your bases. The beautiful Brittany.
Okay, ready? Round two. You ready?
Round two. And Joey scores another takedown. Man, he's been dominant in this facet of the fight. But his opponent continues to get back up. He's doing a great job of moving and transitioning here on the ground. Side control here again.
Oh, he's using the cage, the power out of it. Impressive.
He's got the back. This is where he's outstanding.
Did you see how he put his feet on top of that cage and jumped up?
Good slip of that punch. He slips the punch. Nice leg kick. He's able to block the punch. Stopped nicely. We've reached the midway point of this fight. Nice shot to the body. Nope, can't get it again. Oh, big head kick, Joe.
Right, a head kick, just looking to set him up.
Straight punch.
Big combination.
Vicious shot to the body. Flying knee.
Is that all you got?
Yeah. Kick.
Diaz is like asking for more.
Beautiful body.
And it's Diaz for you.
Big knee. Oh, and he lands.
Oh, Diaz.
Rocked him with that right hand.
This is like, that's all you got!
Oh, looking to finish this fight. Oh, you heard him. Head kick.
Oh, caught him in midair with a head kick.
Oh, flying knee. Combination.
Diaz wants to break. Oh, look at that cut. Oh my god, that uppercut. That uppercut. Someone put that on a poster. That is a new cover photo. Oh my god. He got knocked out. Oh my, he was going for a takedown and Diaz to the floor. Oh my god, that is the with that Max Holloway's knockout last month was the best knockout we saw. That spinning back kick, no, that took it, that took it. Oh man, official decision. Man, it was going good until Paul tried to make this a brawl, and Diaz said, bring it. If that's not knockout of the night, this game is fucked up. Because clearly, that is knockout of the night. How is that not? Can we see it again? Oh my god! Watch it! It is a thing of beauty! Can I save the replay somehow?
I'll
upload that video clip. Is it saved?
YouTube.
I'm putting it out on my Facebook. I really am. The public needs to see that. I'll rename it all later, but oh my. Oh my. Alright, alright. Man. Saint Pierre. Robbie Lawler.
Coming up next, it's a welterweight matchup between George Rush Saint Pierre and knockout artist Robbie Lawler.
Got my guy. Oh, it didn't matter. Here to the USA chance for Robbie Lawler.
Ruthless Robbie Lawler made his UFC debut at 20 years old back in May of 2002. A longtime member of Team Militant, who was also trained with American Top Team, Ruthless Robbie Lawler is one of the most fabulous finishers to ever enter the octagon.
This guy has an incredible ability to control fighters. It's extremely frustrating for the man on the
Ruthless
bottom,
Robbie Lawler.
Once he gets the fight to the ground, oftentimes that is where the fight will remain.
George.
Born raised in Montreal, Quebec, Canada. George Rush St. Pierre. A Canadian national champion in Muay Thai and the most dominant welterweight in UFC history. Trained by Firas Sahabi, GSP may very well be the most well-rounded fighter to ever enter the octagon.
Very disciplined, stellar takedown accuracy, and great endurance. He only goes for the takedown when he knows he can get it. Very disciplined fighter. That's what we saw in Diaz. Paul, we're not going to see happen. St. Pierre is not going to try to go in there and try to get in the brawl. He's going to make this very methodical.
George St. Pierre set to fight today here inside the MGM Grand Garden Arena. Our tale of the tape for this welterweight fight The Canadian is 32. The American is 33. GSP will have a 2-inch reach advantage. And now with our official introductions, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC welterweight division. Introducing first.
I see Herb. I see a Herb. I have a feeling there's a Herbie in here. Don't know why, but I have that feeling. Ruthless. This dude's ruthless. It's no joke.
For this welterweight matchup. And here we go. Fight scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds.
Robbie is such a much more polished striker. In this most recent run in the UFC, he's just a completely different fighter. It's amazing, isn't it? It's incredible. That after all these years, he's still learning and growing.
Lawler's got him in the plum clinch.
And they separate.
And right now, you're seeing a standoff of respect.
St. Pierre with a nice kick. There's the jab. He tags him with the left.
Powerful leg kick from St. Pierre.
Lawler trying to taunt him.
Very nice leg kick by GSP. He slips the punch. Just over 2 on the clock.
Yeah, he's digging into that leg kick.
Lawler with a good knee to the body.
Oh, he's landing some knees there, Mike.
Another big knee. Joe, he has done a great job with that game plan.
Oh! Didn't see that one coming from GSP.
Good inside leg kick.
Oh! Tries for a flying knee.
Great kick by St. Pierre.
Very nice kicks.
And that's just the veteran know-how of St. Pierre.
Just missed with the knee. Lawler gets hit by that right kick.
Look at this.
St. Pierre with the combination.
Doing a good job timing his shots here and landing a great series of punches.
20 seconds on the clock. Solid uppercut by St. Pierre.
No, they're saying Roddy. Roddy.
Kick land.
Georgie, is it such thing?
Georgie!
Is there such thing?
There's a nice leg kick.
St. Pierre went leg kick city. Watch this, Lawler going in for the jab. St. Pierre backed out, leg kick. Boom. Watch this again, same thing. Boom! And look at Herdine just looking.
Some really well
You saw very much what St. Pierre wants to do.
The stunning Brittany Palmer. Round two. Joe, looking back at that last round, George St. Pierre's had his way with his opponent.
Yeah, he had his way in that round. Clearly a dominant round. George St. Pierre is such an incredibly well-rounded fighter. He's one of the best in the world at doing what his opponent least expects. When you think he's going to strike, that's when he takes you down. When you think he's going to take you down, that's when he strikes. And his transitions between striking and grappling are the best in the world.
Look at that. Takedowns landed so far in our fight. That's outstanding. Joe again, a big knee, doing more damage.
Oh, he heard a bad attack.
Punishing the body.
Oh!
Pierre takedown. Top mount.
George has his back. Half guard here.
Just over three now. St. Pierre is looking for the arm.
Can't quite get it. He adjusted the arm bar, turns the hips. And he got out. Wow, that was a deep one. In full guard here.
And he comes over the top to the head. He lands it.
Wow!
He connects with the left.
Lawler.
Vicious shot to the body. Oh, nice knee.
Vicious knees. Solid shot to the body. And again to the midsection.
Nice straight right by George. Huge left hand.
Swings with the left.
Big shot from the clinch. He hurt him with that hook. Vicious knee to the body lands.
Okay. 45 seconds. They're working hard here in the clinch.
Back to over under. Looks like he's got double underhooks here.
Lawler gets that tie clinch again. The knee by Lawler.
Nice high kick.
Standing and trading. Exactly what.
And
we
at an end of the second. St. Pierre had a little bit more issues in that round than he did in the previous round, but still very good round for St. Pierre.
And there's a nice knee to the body.
Lawler was able to do that a lot in this round. At one time, it looked like he had St. Pierre maybe in very deep trouble, but somehow Pierre was able to... I think Lawler made a lit up on that clinch a little too quickly.
Incredible highlights in that round.
The lovely Ariane.
The lovely Ariane. All right, we'll make sure everybody ready.
Third and final round.
Judges are on call. We didn't use them at all 2 weeks ago.
Hard leg kick.
Now the fight's back and over under control.
And he's in the Muay Thai clinch. And separate.
The amount of damage that has been done to his body makes you wonder if he's got a broken rib or two.
Brutal knees.
More big knees by Lawler. Joe, you can see where he is focusing his stand-up attack. Body strikes.
He's doing a great job of timing these shots.
And right into the Muay Thai clinch.
Nice knee.
And back to the knees. And again, they score. They split. Good leg kick by St. Pierre.
Here's the tie clinch again. They separate from the clinch. And from here, transitions to the Muay Thai clinch.
Good move by Lawler.
And again, the knees by Lawler. And they're loose.
And Lawler again able to just cut the ring off. Punishing knees.
He blocks that vicious knee.
And they move out of the clinch.
And the knee to the body. Very good job of timing these shots here. And they disengage from the clinch. 2 minutes remain in the fight. Trying to get a head kick in. And they separate. St. Pierre gets him in the tie clinch again. Nice knee.
Nice knee.
Very nice. Well placed. He's working over under here. He's got the double underhooks.
And he pulls away.
Oh, he lands the roundhouse to the body.
Trying to grab the leg, and he does.
Pierre, takedown.
Solid takedown by George St. Pierre, who might just be the best MMA wrestler of all time. 30 seconds. Trying to take the back here. Both hooks it. This one goes.
And this will be the end of the round. We are going to the decision.
We are awaiting the
very, very interesting decision. Lawler definitely won that third round. Depends on that second round.
Back and forth action. A very, very close fight. An excellent contest to watch. And I'm not really sure who the winner is. And again, here in round two, beautiful technique here. Times that strike perfectly.
St. Pierre had a dominant first round.
Good tight defense, but this strike sneaks through.
And here's Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. All three judges score the contest
29-28.
By unanimous decision, Ruthless.
Oh! And Robbie Lawler gets the victory over St. Pierre. Big victory for Robbie Lawler.
Unanimous decision.
Just able to take that cage in that third round. It was big. I had no answer for Lawler in that third round. Alright, so we're getting for our third match. It's going to be Duffy versus Burns. We had to knock out the Sentry in the first fight. It was a sight in between Paul and Diaz. But can we take a look at the fight statistic? And if I can get control here. For this fight. Significant strikes. Lawler threw a lot more significant strikes than St. Pierre. It was more active than St. Pierre. Didn't go for the takedowns. But it had some ground passes. It's successful when they go to hit the ground. St. Pierre definitely was best round was the first round. But after that, he did slip. I mean, again, he was methodical, but Lawler, with pure aggressiveness, was able to win. And again, that's why they call him Ruthless. But he's not reckless, and he wasn't not reckless there. He was able to get the victory over St. Pierre. So now we get a fight between Duffy and Burns. A lot of people have mentioned, why is that fight so high? And I would agree with you, but it was a scheduling error.
Coming up next, it's a lightweight bout between Joe Duffy and Gilbert Durango Burns.
Oh, I was on that side. I was on Duffy. Yeah, I was. Come on. You lost that one. I'm on my game tonight. I'm the picket. I'm
Gilbert
picking the Irish.
Looking for a big victory tonight.
Oh, the Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. No effect of the Zika virus.
This guy has nasty arm bars and leg locks. It is his specialty. And if he gets a
excellent submissions. Great condition. He's won 10 of his last 11 fights. Mario Yamasaki. Feeling him now. Yeah! Mario Yamasaki, Lance. I know you love this guy.
Gilbert Burns steps inside the octagon, and he's ready to fight.
The Brazilian's ready.
Duffy, coming off a great training camp, he's ready to put on a show.
This guy has great conditioning, Mike. His teammates all talk about the work he puts in the gym. He is just a cardio machine. He never
black belt in Taekwondo and Jiu-Jitsu, great conditioning, great endurance. Goes,
the more the odds are going to swing in his favor.
Set to fight Gilbert Burns. Our tail of the tape for this lightweight collision. Duffy is 28. Burns is 29. Duffy will have a 2-inch reach advantage. And with the official introductions, here's Bruce Buffer.
Here comes Bruce.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC lightweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. Mixed martial artist holding professional record of 10 wins, 1 loss. He stands 5 feet 10 inches tall, weighing in at 155 pounds. Fighting out of Boca Raton, Florida, Gilbert Arenas. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, a boxer holding professional record of 14 wins, 2 losses.
This guy's striker, baby, a boxer. Yeah, that's Mario Yamasaki. He's better than you.
Scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds. White trunks for Burns. Black trunks for Duffy. That's a clean left hand. Oh, now there's a nice leg kick. Good slip on that right hand by Burns.
Duffy, even on a boxer, got efficient ground defense.
Clean jab.
Softening his opponent up, trying to set something up here. Big hook.
Good job of timing strikes here.
Another solid head strike by Duffy.
These guys are going at it here right away, trading blows.
Misses the takedown.
That jab is lightning fast.
He's got the Muay Thai clinch.
First a takedown.
Great movement on the ground.
He's moved back into side control. Now it moves into full guard.
Able to kick himself out of there. Good moves by Duffy.
Beautiful job.
Duffy with a strong combination.
Quick inside leg kick.
Nice slip. And that jab's really effective.
He connected with another uppercut. He's landed a few big ones so far here.
Uppercuts are landing.
He's doing an awesome job. Continuing to score with the uppercut.
He's in half guard. Look for him to set up that uppercut.
Another big shot to the head by Duffy.
Closing the distance. He's got the clinch, Joe.
Oh, there he connected.
He was able to block that big punch to the head.
He's got over and under here. And
good takedown.
Double leg takedown.
45 seconds.
Oh, double on takedown.
He gets in a north-south.
20 seconds. Let's see what he can do from here. Postured up. Half guard right now.
Big punch from the top.
Our first round is in the books.
Got him off.
Yeah, but Duffy used his boxing very efficiently there in that first round.
Here's a powerful leg kick.
Oh yeah.
The takedown defense was good early on, but he got to stripping it up because it looked like Burns is going to be very, very much on them takedowns the most of the fight.
Here we go. Second round. You ready?
Second round. Joe Duffy's got to be more responsible defensively this round because he's already eaten some big knees.
He definitely showed a tendency to get caught with the knee in that round and really has to work on making sure that he tightens up his defense.
He's got a beautiful leg kick. As we go inside the numbers, we update the significant strikes landed. Uppercut.
All right, take down.
Oh my goodness!
Big right hand.
Huge right hand. Vicious ground impact.
He's trying to pass here.
Nice movement on the ground. He's got over under. Under three.
Judo flat.
And again, he's back into side control. Gilbert Burns' ability to pass guard has been very good to him.
His guard passes are a thing of beauty.
Maybe go for a choke. Not the submission expert.
For the rear naked. And
no.
Free the choke.
Nice sweep. He connects with the straight.
Wow, what a back and forth exchange. Looking for the suplex.
And again.
Really good movement on the ground.
Lock it.
Big scores with a huge left.
Suplex down.
Right to half guard. Under a minute remains in the second round.
Caught him with a punch.
Beautiful timing with the left hand. Half guard. And he's back.
Full guard.
Burns gets him in the rubber guard. Burns with the elbow. He's seeing.
And he's trying to use his foot to lock his arm and his punch to him, but that's not going to work. It's the round ends. Huge suplex right there. I gotta give him the utmost credit.
And here's a perfectly executed takedown. And let's take a look at that from a different angle. We've really got a chance to see some awesome action in that round.
The beautiful Ariani.
The beautiful Ariani. good fight we have. It was the third round.
The clinch. And he looks for the takedown. Burns gets the double leg takedown.
Just getting right back up.
Nice leg kick by Duffy.
Excellent takedown defense.
And here we see the number of significant strikes landed so far in the fight.
He's inside control here. He's got full. Oh, no, half guard.
Uh-oh. He mounts. Burns' eyes looking really swollen now. You've got to wonder whether or not it's actually a fractured orbital.
Side control again. Now he's working from north-south.
We're turning it.
Oh, that's an outstanding transition.
Over and over again, these shots are landing.
Great work from the top by Burns. Burns' pass denied.
Back to over under control.
Joey lands another takedown.
Takedown.
Standing wrestling.
Trying to get up. Duffy will get up.
Just 2 minutes remain in the fight.
Mario.
You gonna start this feud with Mario?
He's gonna try to take the back.
Oh, slide and took his back.
Look at his position now.
Side control.
Nicely done.
Back to over under.
Looking for another takedown.
Oh, good.
The takedown here and an excellent throw.
20 seconds.
Now he moves to full guard.
Lost it.
They go the distance. What an outstanding
fight. And a distance it goes. The third round went to a lot on the ground.
I have to say, I think that this one could go either way.
I think Duffy took it, and I think...
This is a very close fight.
Without a doubt, I wouldn't want to be a judge in this fight. I don't know who won it, and I don't think it's fair to even call a winner. Round two, we see some big ground and pound from the top. Round three, top position secured.
In the last fight, I had a feeling I lost, so I don't think I won this fight with Duffy.
Bruce Buffer has gathered the judges' scorecards.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for decision. For the winner by split decision, Irish Joe Duffy!
Split decision victory, but we'll take it.
Earns the victory by split decision.
Let's see if we can see them scorecards. It was definitely a tough fight. Came down to a split decision victory for Joe Duffy. And it was a tough win, but a win nonetheless. Doesn't let me see the scorecards, unfortunately, but we know we can see the strikes. Burns did not land as many strikes. It wasn't as aggressive as Duffy was. Burns was trying to take this fight to the ground, but did one stroke struck with hard shots, but that was mainly in the first round. did a lot of significant strikes in the first round. Second round, tried it a little bit, had difficulties finding Duffy. Third round was really around that Burns probably felt his best thing. He was able to get this to the ground. I mean, 2 out of 6 takedowns. Burns was really adamant about getting this fight to the ground. Duffy did attempt a takedown in the second round and got it, but it was more of a surprise takedown nonetheless. Alright, we're getting ready to go to the co-main event. Take a short break here, 1 second. Be back. We're back. Told you'd be a short break. Because now it's Big Country versus the Black Beast. And no, I didn't make that up. These are these guys' nicknames. We were having fun with it. We're going to let the CPU take care of this to figure out our Black Beast is beating Big Country. I'm going to give you my pick. I'm going. I got to go with Big Country on this one. I really do.
Big Country Nelson and Derek the Black Beast.
But I know I'm going to be giving my opinions throughout the fight. But first of all, I have to go and send us to someone real special. Listen up. There's only one person going to win this fight, and it's Big Country Roy Nelson. He's a hillbilly. And when you're sitting there and you're going against a hillbilly, it's going to be strength. It's going to be the character that we build, only how we do it. And Big Country out of Las Vegas, Nevada, who has the hometown crown for him today, is going to beat Lewis. I'm predicting knockout second round. Second round. Book it. Call your mama and tell her in the second round, Lewis is going to get knocked out by Big Country, Roy Nelson. Thank you, Billy.
Derek Lewis, back in the
there's nothing like seeing two heavyweights go in the ring and throw bombs. And that's exactly what we're about ready to see.
Jiu-Jitsu black belt under Enzo Gracie, we rarely see his submission skills. In fact, most of his fights never go to the ground, unless, of course, it's his opponent after he eats a big right hand from Roy Nelson.
When you look Jiu-Jitsu at Roy black Nelson, belt, you can be confused. Can go to the ground if he wants to, as you just heard Joe Rose say, but typically doesn't. But that means he has the ability not to, if Lewis wanted to take this to the ground. It ain't going to the ground, but I don't think we have to worry about that. I think we're going to see a stand-up punching power.
The elite fighters of the world. Our tale of the tape for this heavyweight fight. Lewis is 31. Nelson is 39. Lewis.
I guess I always do like to take a topic when we do one of these fights. And again,
Bruce Buffer.
There is things in the UFC we want to talk about. There's a lot of things going on. There's the whole CM Punk is going to be fighting in September, but we'll have a chance to talk about that in later broadcasts. One of the things I wanted to talk about is a lot of... He's out of Houston, Texas. So one of the things I really wanted to talk to you about is how UFC fighters, I mean, it was a big comment that Cerrone made that we should get paid more, and a lot of other people have started to come out. Dana White has said that they're not going to change the pay scale. And I just wanted to tune in, even though my opinion really doesn't matter, and I don't think anybody really cares. I honestly have seen it, and I think I've done a little bit of research on it, not as much as maybe other people have on it, but I really do believe UFC fighters should be getting paid more. They had this huge deal with Fox Sports. I think it's a bit, I'm not sure the exact figures, and I'm not going to lie and bring a number out, but I want to, it's a high figure. And these fighters should get a part of that figure. I mean, I think I saw something that Cerrone made only $70,000 on a fight. To me, that's absurd. I mean, there's no way that Cerrone only made $70,000 on a fight. I mean, everybody should be coming away with about $100,000 at a fight, a minimum, I really believe. But I know Cerrone fights a lot, and you say, oh, he's... But they're not getting paid for, you know, training and all that stuff. And training costs a lot, and you got your people and all that stuff. Again, I don't know if that's all taken out or what, but I highly doubt it. Whoa, that was a big shot. Now, Lewis is in trouble, but he's able to escape off. But, I mean, again, I don't have a lot of research in it, but I do have a little bit. I can say the figures. But I do believe UFC fighters in general, and I'm not talking about the big names. I'm not talking about McGregor or the Aldos and the Silvas. I mean, they paid pretty handsomely. Should they get a little bit more? Probably. I mean, UFC 200 is going to make a lot of money. I mean, the fighters should get a little bit of that, a little bit more of that piece of the pot. I mean, they're the ones that go in there and risk their lives and get beat in the face. So, I mean, they should get some more, but really I think it's the under guys should get a little bit more, because those are the guys, I know they don't bring the money to the sport, but they have the possibility of getting up to that level, and I think there needs to be an increase in the salaries. I mean, they've had this huge deal for Fox Sports. There should be more fight money out there, and I really believe there is more fight money out there, and it could be improved. Nice knee. I mean, one of the things, I mean, what is it, the fight bonus is like $50,000 fight bonus from like, and I mean, I thought he thought that, oh, that's just a short piece of change, you may make like a little bit more, but if $50,000 is almost more than half what you brought in, I mean, it's absurd to me, I really believe. So, I mean, that's just my opinion of it. But again, I mean, people can disagree. Some people think they just paid a lot, but I mean, it is the most dangerous sport out there. I mean, it's no softies fighting in the UFC. I mean, you're going in there and you're getting your face smashed in, and I think you should be compensated for it. I mean, the pay-per-view buy rates are high. Everything with the UFC is good. And yeah, I really do believe, yeah, there should be a better pay scale. Definitely want a guy like Brock Lesnar to come in and get his money. But if he loses, he starts the WWE to fall back on. Other guys need to have that benefit of getting paid. And because you never, in this sport, you really never know when you get knocked down, your career is over. Right? They need to make as much money as possible.
And here's another beautiful leg kick.
As for that fight, I thought Big Country had the majority, but it looks like they're showing a lot of Lewis highlights. But again, Joe Rogan has been wrong more times than not. So Lewis, Big Country. Again, UFC 200 around the bend. Next Saturday, man, it's real, man. We're 8 days away from the biggest card ever. Jones, Cornier. We got Lesnar and Hunt, Aldo and Aguilar, Amisha Tate and Amanda Nunez. I mean, it's huge. I mean, there's going to be a title fight on in that card. What? At 10:30, 10:40 Eastern Standard Time, there's gonna be a title fight.
He's doing a really good job.
It's going to be huge.
Excellent feint with the kick.
Take a look at the significant strikes on. Nelson caught by that inside leg.
He lands an excellent.
Man, I can't wait for UFC 200. I don't know about all y'all. I'm looking forward to seeing Jones, Cornier. I will let you know my pick next week. I'm still a little hesitant on who I'm going to pick, but I think I have a good idea. Lesnar and Hunt. I think I have a pick for that one.
And he reverses position. Full guard now. Postures up here.
Nelson. On the ground, and we're on the ground a little bit right here, a lot.
He's taking his back.
These two big guys. But Lewis is getting the better of this fight right now.
Solid right by Lewis.
He's looking to take the back.
Oh no. Big Country getting that back, man. It could be over.
Lewis gets it back in his guard.
I'm surprised Mario Bsucka has stepped in yet. But anyway, back to what I was saying. UFC 200 is going to be huge. It's going to be the best fight. The best of the best on that card. I'm looking forward to it. I'm looking forward to seeing Aldo back in the ring. I don't know about other people. Yeah, of course I'm looking forward to the main event. Of course I'm looking forward to seeing Brock Lesnar in the octagon to see how he can do it after being away from the UFC but still being in the WWE. How that plays off, how that dynamic may give us some insight on CM Punk, but there's a little different dynamics, which we talked about before. Lesnar, All-American collegiate wrestler. CM Punk, not so much. He wasn't. So, different backgrounds, but... Oh, that was a good move by Big Country.
He postures into place.
Big left hand.
That was a hard one, Mike.
All right, I'll make sure you get that guard open.
Hurt him with that right. And now he moves to his
back. Oh, man.
And the mount again.
But, I mean, I'm looking forward to seeing Aldo back in the ring. Last time we saw Aldo in the ring, he was knocked out to a part where he didn't know what happened. I mean, and I picked Aldo, and I was humbled, and all that stuff, and all that McGregor hype happened, and it lasted a very short amount of time, but that's side point.
Here's a powerful knee to the
we're talking about Aldo getting in the ring, fighting for the interim featherweight title, which I think it's still for the interim featherweight title, don't quote me, I'm almost positive. I personally think it should be for the featherweight title, because I don't think when your last two fights, you haven't defended your featherweight title. Now, admit, the first time when he was going to go fight, he was going to fight Dos Anjos, to champion versus champion to try to get two titles. But apparently we're going to see the Diaz fight. I don't know if we're ever going to see the Dos Anjos McGregor fight again. I mean, it was scheduled the first time he was going to do that. He was going to have two different belts and two different weight classes. I don't know if he's still going to do that. I mean, he right now, according to hell, I mean, he believes he got to save face and beat Diaz. That he wasn't prepared for Diaz, all that stuff. We'll see about that. I personally think it's a better idea not to have McGregor and Diaz main event UFC 200. I mean, for UFC 200, everybody talking about how Brock Lesnar got so high up on the card. But let's talk about McGregor is not defending a belt, and he's high up on the card. I mean, yeah, he's a champion, but he's not defending a belt.
His opponent commits, and he answers with the combination. Well done.
I mean, and I'm still a believer that it has to be about the belt. Because I see what boxing has went through, and I don't want to see that for the UFC. I really don't. So, I think in the end of the day, Jones, Cornier is the best decision for UFC 200. Even if that whole he didn't promote the fight thing didn't happen, I believe UFC 200 will be better because they have a championship fight. And they have Jones, a guy who's a mainstay, I believe. Main event, and it historically is going to be remembered better than a just in the moment decision. And what the hell is going on here?
Wow, what a huge block! His left eye's closing up.
Lewis, man, is doing a great job in his fight.
Good knee by Lewis. He's in a better position here with the tie clinch.
I hate you going to work. There's the work being done. Big country trying to get out of there. Man.
A big shot to the head.
Lewis is going in Big Country's home and taking it to him.
Vicious shot to the body.
Man, they're going at it.
Completes the takedown. Trying to take the back here.
Oh man, country, get on top of you, man. It could be the end of your life.
Forward. Great punch by Lewis.
Man, we are using the judges today. 2 weeks ago, the judges. We're pretty much away. It was all knockout, and I think we had a submission. Don't quote me. Today we have gone to our third decision.
In a back and forth battle, both fighters were able to do damage.
I think Lewis got that fight.
But the question is, in the minds of the judges, who did more damage and who has earned the victory?
Incredibly close fight, incredibly exciting fight, and you're right. The ground and pound was the big story of this fight on both sides.
Yeah, we thought it was going to be more of a stand-up fight in this fight, but apparently we got more of a ground-and-pound jiu-jitsu type fight.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 3 rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. For the winner by split decision...
Not a split decision. And the Black Beast beats Big Country. Somewhere hillbillies around the world, no offense, are not happy. And it's... Las Vegas crowd not happy. But it happened. The Black Beast beats Big Country. So, as we look at the statistics there, Lewis was more active. He landed more significant strikes. He had to, when he threw, it was definitely significant. Percentage-wise, and here we look at the total fight. Landed more, threw more, almost as many as Nelson tried to attempt. But Nelson was more persistent accuracy. But it looks like the judges today have been more about setting the tone of the pace, going after the fight, instead of more just that overall. I mean, they are really big on the aggression, it looks like, today. Alright, it is main event time. It is for the lightweight championship. The same fight we're going to see in real life for the lightweight title, Dos Anjos defending against Alvarez. We're going to see in our EA Sports Fight League, because in our EA Sports Fight League, Dos Anjos has the belt. Alvarez is the challenger. Here we go. The lightweight title's on the line. Here we go.
Eddie Alvarez, ready to go.
The fighting pride of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
Lightweight champion.
As he steps towards this cage, he understands this is one of the biggest moments in his life. The biggest moment in his career. He is looking
wrestling background, excellent striker, great endurance. The one thing they always say about every Alvarez, he's a born fighter.
Perfectly. He is in outstanding shape. He has a great game plan.
But he knows how to win.
And he believes that he will emerge the new champion of the world tonight after this fight.
The
Janeiro, Brazil, Rafael Dos Anjos. He is trained under the guidance of Professor Rafael Cordero. Strong, powerful, great grappler, and knockout power. Those are the many reasons why Rafael Dos Anjos became the 11th Brazilian champion in UFC history.
Headed to the cage right now. He's in the groove. He is in his prime right now. His training for this bout has been perfect. He believes he has a solid game plan, and he's ready to step in here and retain his title. He is well prepared for this contest.
Our tale of the tape for this lightweight championship fight. The Brazilian is 31. The American is 32. Dos Anjos will have a 2-inch reach. With the official introductions, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. When the action begins, the referee in charge of the
Herdeen.
And now, this is the
let Bruce Buffer do it like nobody else.
Herdeen
talking to
him. And this started at the weigh-ins yesterday, where the stare down was intense. It's time to get things started. And here we go. The lightweight belt is on the line. Tonight's main event is scheduled for five-minute rounds. White trunks for Alvarez. Black trunks for the champion. Joe, this championship matchup has taken a life of its own. There has been so much.
Joro, you're starting to say this every time,
so
man.
Much bad blood. This is by far one of the biggest title fights in UFC history. This is
dude, you're saying this every week
massive
now.
Massive world title fight. The implications are huge across the sport. This is about as important.
Oh, caught him in the back of the head.
You will ever witness. Big kick just missed. Nice jab. Huge
grounds.
And he connects. Nicely done. He slipped the punch. Little inside leg kick. He's doing some damage with those kicks. Uppercut. Trying to shoot.
I'll cool down after I fall and uppercut. I'm not working.
Soft kick by Dos Anjos. Oh, that's a big straight. Ooh, that's a powerful body kick right there. He's got an over and an under here. Goes for a single.
under 2 minutes now.
Those Anjos were. Whoa, good shot.
And separate.
Ah, nice straight punch. He'll look for the single.
Takedown.
Grab the leg, completes the takedown.
Wow, look at that.
How good is that?
Uh-oh. He hip escapes. He's out of the full mount.
Dos Anjos dive.
Ah, nice sweep. Very good move. Trying to get control here.
And he gets out of that rear naked choke. Nice reversal here.
And right into the Muay Thai clinch. Good knee from the clinch by Dos Anjos. Joe, that's another big knee. And he's done a ton of damage with those tonight. Joe, that was a brutal knee to the body. What a way to work at the finish of this round.
And there's a nice knee to the body.
Don't take round, come on.
Dos Anjos made it stole that round.
And here's another knee to the body. And here's one more.
We're looking at the ass of Eddie Alvarez right there, how it moved when he got kneed.
What a great round. This fight is really shaping up.
Dos Anjos won our EA Sports Fight League title, of course, by beating Benson Henderson.
The lovely Brittany.
The lovely Brittany.
Round number two.
You're off today. You got to know the difference between the lovely Ariane and the lovely Brittany and the beautiful Brittany and the beautiful Ariane.
Set for round two. Lightweight title fight. Joe, just like we saw in the last round, the champion so far is the better fighter. He is dictating where this fight takes place. And once again, he looks sensational.
Oh, turning it.
Oh, and reversed.
Joe, this is dangerous.
Look at that. Again. He's got the back again. In half guard position.
Nice work to the body by Dos Anjos. Man, those body shots have been lethal. Look at the bruising on his right side.
Oh.
Nice right by Alvarez.
Dos Anjos getting up.
Joe, he's got his opponent up against the fence. Great trip, and he completes the takedown. 3 minutes remain in the round. Man, he really turned on that inside leg kick. Good connection with the straight by Dos Anjos.
Oh, Dos Anjos was just unloading there. Leg kick. Now.
Oh, that's a good shot right there.
Very good shot.
Huge bomb from the top. Oh, big right hand.
Oh, he's
no! Oh, no! New lightweight champion!
Round and pound.
Let's check out the action on our fight replay.
Let's look at the replay and see the end of this fight. This is the huge...
Alvarez wins and stuns the world by winning a lightweight title here.
Let's see that again.
Setting the city of Philadelphia pole.
And he's out.
And here is Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 21 seconds of round number 2. Declaring the winner by knockout and new UFC lightweight champion.
champion of the world, Eddie Alvarez.
Eddie Alvarez is the new UFC lightweight champion. And once again, a great night of fights. For my partner, Joe Rogan,
Alvarez steals the show. Until next time, able to win this right match. Inside. And wins by knockout nonetheless. The win it all. Unbelievable. Alvarez, that second round, winning it by KO. Taking home the lightweight title. Astounding victory for Eddie Alvarez. Great way to end it. Alvarez able to be the new champion of the world. Of course, the knockout tonight had to be Dia. That's what we had to check. Fight tonight, Lewis and Nelson. A hell of a fight. Great action all the way around. We will see you next time. Well, excuse me, yeah. Get off that. We will see you next time. UFC 200. I don't know how big it's going to be, but it's going to be huge. Just to let you all know, we are ready for it. Next week, better be there. It's going to be, it's just going to be huge.